EE Domus Guide Installation. Unbox the controller with its feeder and network cable. Write down the serial number located at the bottom of the product. Turn on the device using the power supply. When it is connected for the first time, the EE Domus driver will be updated. This process can take several minutes. Registration. In order to connect to the EE Domus access portal, you have to enter this address, https://secure.eedomus.com. For the registration, you will be asked for an email, username, phone number with international prefix, password, and the acceptance of the terms of license. You will be asked for a phone number to confirm the account, and then you will be done. When you log in for the first time, you will be asked for the serial number of the controller. Overview of the EE Domus portal. Peripherals are grouped in pages, called panels. Each peripheral will appear in a small window, known as widget. There are two kinds of panels, one kind for rooms and the other kind for the users that are going to be assigned to them. Click on a panel to browse it. You will see the breadcrumb showing the path at the top of the window. The path always starts with the home button. Click it anytime you need it. You will be able to find the same peripheral in different paths. Keep in mind that the easiest way to find it is going to the room where it is located. From this part, you will be able to configure the whole system. From here, you will configure the controller, add peripherals, and you will be able to set them up. You will only use this part now in the first time startup, and when you add a new peripheral. Peripherals. In this section of the EE Domus controller, you will find three kinds of peripherals: physical peripherals, external peripherals attached to our network, and virtual peripherals. Dashboard. In this page, you will be able to see the different data stored for the EE Domus. You can see it either graphically or in a grid. You will see the peripherals with its data. Temperature, power consumptions, humidities, light levels, etc. The My Account tab will allow you to manage the different accounts. The administrator, user, or root will be the one with privileges, and he will have permission for everything. If the link between the EE Domus controller and the server fails, the administration can receive a notification by email, SMS, push, according to the configuration chosen. On this page, you will also find the API credentials. You can create them, revoke them, or copy them. The credentials will help you build the HTTP calls with the correct syntax. The Service tab contains information about the account, either premium or free. The Secondary Account tab allows you to create accounts for other users and give them permissions. In the tab Account Connected, you can link an account to different controllers. In the Programming tab, you can add new functionalities to our peripherals. You can make them interact between themselves. From here, you can make and manage the scenes or rules. In the tab List, you will find the existing programs. From here, you can edit their parameters and see the associated rules. In the tab New Programming, you can create programs predefined for the EE Domus. The Agenda tab will allow us to create our own schedule in order to the EOMs know when you are going into the house, what time, according to the week, month, and year. In the Rules tab, you will find different rules created for us or created automatically by the system. This tab will allow us to deactivate a rule without having to delete it. It will also allow you to create, edit, and duplicate rules. Display settings. Click on the small arrow next to the configuration button, then click on display settings. This window will allow you to change the background image and the number of columns. You can also choose a personalized image or modify the icon style. You can also add peripherals directly to the home window by clicking on the pencil on each panel. On the window, you have different options, such as widget position, widget height, widget width, and number of columns. The widget position can be automatic and thus sorted by alphabetical order, or personalized, ordered by ourselves. The All Displays section will allow you to configure the kind of icons that you will use. The section Only This Display allows us to modify the background color of the screen. The display wallpaper will let you choose a different picture for any room. With the opacity wallpaper, you can highlight the wallpaper or let it in the background so as to better see the icons. Now, click on the Finish button. You will find three buttons: Display Type, Device Configuration, and Customize Display. The available display types are Curve, which show us a time curve with all the data in a period of time. Bar chart. It shows a histogram with fractions of time, with the measures with a given period of time. Circular gauge, linear gauge, and simple, which just show us the icons for the sensor and the current measure.